In the last movie, we created our registration system. So in this movie, we will create our login page. So first we have to design our login page. So back to my editor, I will use my file of basic.html and I will save this file as login.php. Now first let's bring this file in our editor, but before let's change its title to login, clicking on login.php. So this is our login.php file. Now in this file, we will not have any type of list in the menu bar. So I will remove all of these links from here because the basic purpose of this login page to give a window where the admin can log in. And it also recommended that there should not be any link of this login page on your public domain. Let's remove first of all these list items. So right in this, here you can see I have this UL list items. So I will remove all of my list items. So removing this one, saving it, and let's refresh our page. So I just have this jazibakram.com. Now let's also remove this header. So right in my header area, I will remove this whole I tag for font awesome, and also let's remove this basic from here. So if I save this one and refresh this page, you can see we have this header. The reason why you are seeing this black header here is because of this padding y-3 on our header, and also I have this h1 empty tag here. So if I remove this h1, you will see a little bit of decrease in the padding, see, like this. But still we have this padding just because of padding y-axis 3. So after this header, we will have just our footer here. I will start with the comment here. So starting this main area with one section, and that section will have a bootstrap class of container, and let's give it some padding on the y-axis. So adding the padding, and let's also give it some margin bottom of 4. And inside this section, we will have another div with the bootstrap class of row. And then inside this div of row, we will have another div with the bootstrap class of call dash sm dash 6. Let's add some style so that you can see the structure of this div. So I will add the minimum height of 400 pixel, and for background, I will go with the red. So if I save this one and refresh this page, you can see we have this red div right here. So I will add offset class to make this div in the center of the page. So adding offset first 3 column on my smaller screen. So SM-3. See, now it's in the center of the page. Now inside this div, I will add a card in which we will add our form. So for adding card, we need another div with the bootstrap class of card. And let's give it some background of bg-secondary. And its text would be text-light. And then for the card header, we will have another div. In which I will have this H4 heading. Then we will have another div with the bootstrap class of card-body. And it will have a background of bg-dark. So saving this one and refreshing my page, so you can see it right here. This is our body and this is our card header. Now let's remove this red color from here. So removing the red color from the background, and now inside this div of header will not have anything else. So After that, I will have this form. And for its action attribute, we will have the same page of login.php, and the method of this one will be post. Now inside this form, let's add couple of field. So adding one div with the bootstrap class of form-group, and then adding a label here. So the label will be for username, and then we will have one span tag that will have our custom class of field info. So adding the text here, user name. Then right after our label, we will have another div for adding the input group of font awesome. So it will have bootstrap class of input dash group, and it will have some margin to the bottom. Then inside this div, we will have another div with the bootstrap class of input dash group dash prepend, and then inside it we will have span tag with the bootstrap class of input dash group dash text. Its text would be text dash white, and for the span tag we'll have our font awesome with the class of FAS FA dash user. Then after this div, we'll have our input field with the type of text, and adding the bootstrap class of form dash control. Its name will be username with the capital U, and its ID will be same as the label. So if I save this one and refresh this page, you can see we got this input field with this font awesome prepend. Let's also change the color of this one so I can apply the bootstrap class on this span tag. So the class will be bg dash info. See, now we got this sky blue color at the background. Now same like this field, I can copy this whole form group and I can change it for my password field. So it will be for password, and the font awesome would be fa dash lock, and for the field it would be name password, ID will be password with the lower p, and its type would be password as well. So saving this one, refreshing my page. So after that we will have our login button. So right after this form group, I will add one input tag. Its type would be submit. Its name would be submit as well. And for the class, it would be btn-info and btn-block. So saving this one, refreshing my page. You can see we got this button right here. So let's add the text on this button. I can add the text in the value attribute. So login for the text. So if I refresh this page, you can see this login button. So this is it for designing. You can see that this black header is not occupying this welcome back. So we must have placed it after the card header div. So you can see that this div is starting from here and it's not wrapping up our welcome back. So I have to cut it from line 45 and I can put it on line 44. So if I refresh my page now, you can see now we have the background to our whole body of black. You can have this card sticking here at this position, or you can make it a bit down so that your footer should be placed right at the end of your browser. So I can do that by adding couple of br tag around this card. So right before this card, I will add the br tag. So if I save this one and refresh my page, you can see we still need couple of br tag. And instead, if I go with the minimum height, so let's make it 500. So if I remove one of the br tag, now it's perfect. Now in the next movie, we will add the PHP to this login.php page.